If you are an academic or industry professional involved in microbiome science, you will have heard of the terms 16S sequencing and shotgun sequencing. In this video, we break down the differences between these two types of microbiome sequencing approaches, analyze the pros and cons of each, and discuss the factors to consider when deciding on the best sequencing approach for your microbiome study. In the year 2000, it cost roughly $100 million to sequence the entire human genome, whilst today it costs only about $1,000. These rapid developments in sequencing technologies have made sequencing much faster and cheaper, and are largely responsible for the fascinating advances in microbiome research in recent times. However, there are now different types of sequencing options available for microbiome studies, which are accessible to all researchers, companies, and industries interested in the microbiome space. Whether it is human, animal, or environmental microbiomes that you are interested in, it's important to understand and consider the pros and cons of the traditional sequencing methods, 16S rRNA, versus newly developed shotgun metagenomic sequencing. So firstly, what is 16S sequencing? A form of amplicon sequencing, 16S rRNA gene sequencing targets and reads a region of the 16S rRNA gene, which is found in all bacteria and archaea, meaning this sequencing can only identify these types of microorganisms. Other types of amplicon sequencing can identify other microorganisms, such as ITS sequencing for fungi or 18S sequencing for protists. The process of 16S sequencing involves a few simple steps. Firstly, extracting DNA from the sample. Next, performing PCR on the DNA sample to amplify one or more selected hypervariable regions of the 16S rRNA gene, as well as adding molecular barcodes to each cleaned DNA sample in order to multiplex multiple samples together. Next, it's necessary to clean up and size select the amplified DNA to remove impurities. Next, it's necessary to pool samples together in equal proportions, then quantify the libraries, and finally sequenced all the pooled samples. The output of 16S sequencing provides reads, which are strings of DNA sequence that can be analyzed using a number of basic bioinformatic steps, which when combined together are known as pipelines. These bioinformatic pipelines remove sequencing errors or dubious reads in order to clean the data, which can then be aligned to microbial genomic databases in order to accurately identify and profile the bacteria and archaea that were present in the samples. A number of 16S sequencing pipelines are available, including CHIME, MOTHER, USearch, UPARS, some of which have extensive tutorials and online user interfaces in order to support researchers without bioinformatics expertise. Shotgun metagenomic sequencing involves randomly breaking or fragmenting DNA into many small pieces, much like a shotgun would break something up into many pieces. These fragmented pieces of DNA are then sequenced, and their DNA sequences are stitched back together using bioinformatics to identify the species and genes present in the sample. Unlike 16S sequencing, shotgun metagenomic sequencing can read all genomic DNA in a sample, rather than just one specific region of DNA. For microbiome studies, this means that shotgun sequencing can identify and profile bacteria, fungi, viruses, and many other types of microorganisms at the same time. As genomes are sequenced, it is also possible to identify and profile microbial genes that are present in the sample, known as the metagenome, which provide additional information about microbiome functional potential. The process for metagenomic sequencing involves a few extra steps compared to 16S sequencing, but these steps can vary slightly depending on the methods used. Firstly, extract DNA from your sample. Two, tagmentation, a process which cleaves and tags DNA with adapter sequences, priming the fragmented DNA for ligation of molecular barcodes. Three, cleaning up your fragmented DNA sample to remove tagmentation reagent impurities. Four, performing PCR to amplify tagmented DNA samples, as well as adding molecular barcodes to each sample. Five, size selection and cleaning up of the DNA to remove impurities after the PCR steps. Six, pool samples together in equal proportions. Seven, library quantification of the pooled samples. And eight, sequencing pooled samples. Shotgun sequencing reads require more complex bioinformatic methods in order to analyze results. Shotgun metagenomics bioinformatics pipelines also perform quality filtering steps after which the clean sequencing data can either be assembled to create partial or full microbial genomes using pipelines such as MegaHit, or aligned to databases of microbial marker genes using pipelines such as Metaflan and Human. Many of these pipelines now also have online tutorials and user interfaces in order to assist those without bioinformatics expertise with analyses. The final results provide details of the relative abundances of bacteria, fungi, viruses, and other microbes in the sample, as well as the relative abundances of curated lists of microbial genes, for example, metabolic or antibiotic-resistant genes. So as explained, shotgun metagenomic sequencing provides more information than 16S sequencing. However, shotgun metagenomic sequencing has some limitations. This table outlines the relative merits of both types of microbiome sequencing and can be found in the linked blog on the Microbiome Insights website. Let's go through some of these factors to consider in detail. The first factor to consider is cost. Although shotgun metagenomic sequencing provides much more data than 16S rRNA gene sequencing, you will have to pay for that extra data. Shotgun metagenomic sequencing is usually at least double to triple the cost of 16S sequencing, although costs are falling continuously. In order to work around this data versus cost dilemma, some researchers conduct 16S sequencing on all of their samples, in addition to shotgun metagenomic sequencing on a small subset of their samples in their study. The cost per sample of sequencing will always depend on the depth of sequencing. Deeper sequencing usually means more data and analysis options. In recent years, however, a new variation of shotgun metagenomic sequencing, termed shallow shotgun sequencing, has managed to bridge the gap between sequencing data and cost. By combining many more samples into a single sequencing run and using a modified protocol that uses less reagents for sequencing library preparation, shallow shotgun sequencing is able to provide more than 97% of the compositional and functional data obtained using deep shotgun metagenomic sequencing at a cost similar to 16S gene sequencing. Shallow metagenomics is best suited for studies that benefit from the statistical power afforded by a high number of replicates. In its current form, shallow metagenomics is most reliable if it is used for sample types with a high microbial to host DNA ratio, for example, fecal samples. The next factor to consider is taxonomic resolution. 16S sequencing is generally limited to identifying bacteria at the genus level, for example, bifidobacteria. Shotgun metagenomic sequencing, on the other hand, can identify bacteria and other microorganisms at a species level, for example, Bifidobacterium longum, or sometimes even a strain level, for example, Bifidobacterium longum 35624, by profiling single nucleotide variants in metagenomic data. Therefore, for broad profiling of bacterial microbiomes, 16S sequencing would be sufficient. However, if it is necessary to look a little more deeply at the species and strains within your microbiome of interest, shotgun metagenomic sequencing will be more powerful. Taxonomic coverage is also an important consideration. As discussed, 16S sequencing targets a gene that is only present in bacteria and archaea. Although bacteria make up a majority of human microbiomes, there is a growing interest in the fungal, viral, and eukaryotic proportions of human and other microbiomes. If you are only interested in bacteria, 16S gene sequencing is sufficient. However, if you are interested in multiple microbial kingdoms, shotgun metagenomic sequencing will be more suitable. It is important to consider, however, that the ability to identify bacteria, viruses, and eukaryotic microorganisms simultaneously and accurately will strongly depend on the DNA extraction method used on your sample. For example, RNA viruses cannot be detected in a DNA extract, and also on the bioinformatics and pipelines used. Microbiome research is now moving beyond profiles of microbial taxa in a sample, known as the taxonomic composition. In fact, evidence from large human microbiome studies suggests that functional metagenomic data may provide more power for identifying differences between healthy and diseased microbiomes. 16S sequencing cannot directly profile microbial genes or functions. However, some bioinformatic tools, such as PyCrust, are available to predict microbiome function with 16S gene data. Shotgun metagenomic sequencing, on the other hand, can provide comprehensive data on microbial gene content. Therefore, if you are interested in microbiome functional profiles, such as antibiotic-resistant genes or carbohydrate-degrading genes, shotgun sequencing is the more suitable choice. The caveat is that current databases are limited in identifying many functional genes. Sample type is the next important consideration. As 16S sequencing uses PCR to amplify a specific region of DNA, there is little chance of amplification from the host DNA. Shotgun metagenomic sequencing, on the other hand, sequences all the DNA in a sample, meaning that non-microbial reads may obscure the microbiome results. This is especially apparent in human microbiome studies, using samples that may contain lots of human DNA, such as skin swabs or cheek swabs, when looking at the skin and oral microbiomes. For such samples, 16S sequencing may be more suitable. Next, although shotgun metagenomic sequencing provides more data than 16S sequencing, the data potential can only be used with the appropriate tools and analysis. Metagenomic sequencing data is complex, and therefore it requires more powerful computers, time, and expertise to generate meaningful results from large data sets. 16S sequencing, however, generates simpler data that can be analyzed more easily by non-experts. Before deciding on 16S sequencing versus shotgun sequencing, it is important to consider the bioinformatic analysis capabilities available to you. Microbiome Insights have a team of bioinformatic experts that are happy to help with your 16S rRNA or shotgun metagenomic sequencing studies. Databases are a very important consideration for your microbiome study. As 16S sequencing has been more commonly used in microbiome studies to date, there are a number of well-curated databases available to identify microorganisms present in your sample. On the other hand, there is currently a lack of full reference genomes of certain microbial species in databases used for shotgun metagenomic sequencing. Therefore, in microbiome samples that have not been previously well characterized, such as soil or marine samples, shotgun sequencing may actually identify fewer taxa than 16S sequencing. Full microbial genomes are continuously being added to these databases, however, meaning that shotgun metagenomic sequencing will be able to identify these understudied microorganisms as efficiently as 16S sequencing in the future. To get an idea of what sequencing approach you might take for your study, let's go through some study examples. Example study A is assessment of the bacterial microbiome of Amazonian soil. As discussed, bacterial 16S rRNA databases may be more suitable for identifying rare or understudied taxa, as corresponding full reference genomes may not currently be available for these species. In this example study, 16S sequencing may provide more taxonomic resolution than metagenomic sequencing. Example study B is assessing changes in microbiome composition and antimicrobial gene carriage following a fecal transplant. The primary advantage of metagenomic sequencing is its ability to provide functional microbiome data relating to microbial genes. In this study example, metagenomic sequencing would be the more suitable choice, as it would provide simultaneous assessment of the changes in the gut microbiome composition, in addition to detailed profiling of antimicrobial resistant genes and their hosts. Final Finally, example study C is examining daily fluctuations in gut microbiome following a 2-week dietary fiber intervention. Although dietary interventions often change gut microbiome composition, in certain circumstances, changes are only evident at a functional level. In this example study, shallow shotgun sequencing would be a powerful approach to assess both compositional differences, such as species or strain changes, and functional differences in the gut microbiome following a dietary intervention at a cost similar to that of 16S rRNA sequencing. So if you are planning a microbiome study, we created this guide for anyone interested in studying microbial communities. It covers all the key steps from study design and execution through to analysis and interpretation, including many useful resources and supporting documents. Microbiome Insights provide 16S rRNA sequencing, as well as shallow and deep shotgun metagenomic sequencing services, plus extensive bioinformatic expertise. If you still have questions about your microbiome study and the type of sequencing to use, the Microbiome Insights team will be happy to help.